Data, it's everywhere, right? You can't run your business without it. It fuels everything that we do. However, data can be hard to manage and make use of effectively. Where do we store it? How do we use it? What does data even mean for us? Every single day, I see businesses stuck working with clunky legacy systems and manual reporting procedures. In this fast-paced digital age, we all know there's a better way, right? But making a change and orientating your business to be slick, seamless, and automated and data-driven can be daunting or outright impossible. I'm here to tell you that's simply not the case. Our equation for operational excellence is quality and simplicity equals productivity. Now, data quality is super important, but it's complicated to manage. Correct and complete data sets are key to simplicity and trust in your data. With low data quality, your client materials might look unprofessional, showing incorrect or out-of-date data. Not to mention, sales pipelines and cash flow forecasting will often be misleading, just to name a few. Everyone starts to question the integrity of your business's data, and the opportunity for any meaningful reporting or analytics is lost. Now, data is stored all over the place, right? In a variety of different systems, databases. So how do you go about managing the data quality across all of these different systems and across your entire business? Well, let's take a moment to consider this use case, right? We've got systems A, B, and C, all with their own set of controls and governance rules. And quality needs to be monitored across all of these and then reported centrally to be managed effectively. Now, manipulating and joining the data from all of these disparate sources has traditionally been a nightmare. Take a look at this solution template that we've already delivered to a number of happy clients. Here we go. We've got our three data sets visualized right here on screen. We've got A, B, and C, all with different shapes of data. How do we bring them in? What we do is we use our tool of choice in this particular template called Alteryx. Now, Alteryx is a world-class, code-free data preparation, blend, and analytic tool. What we do is we bring all of these disparate data sources into the single instance here of Alteryx. We cleanse it, we join it, and we transform it. Within Alteryx, we then specify all of the different issues we want to highlight and track within our visualization a little bit later on. Once that data's come through Alteryx, it then comes on through in a clean, concise data set. That data set can be visualized here in Excel or might be put into SQL perhaps, but then from there, it goes into the visualization tool of your choice. In this particular example, we've elected to use Power BI, but that's completely up to you. Now, this central dashboard here is where management and stakeholders will go in to monitor that quality. Now, the beauty of this particular solution is that it's rerunnable. That's right. So when we come from source, we want to bring in the new set of data, fresh set of data that comes into Alteryx. I simply click onto play. Here we go. It runs on through this entire process and straight into the visualization. Now, let's take a look at what some bad quality data might look like. Okay? We've got data automatically being loaded into our CRM, for example. We've got missing first and last names. We might have a missing email. How do we contact that person? We don't even know what country they're in, for example. Maybe I'm monitoring a deal I've got with a client, but there's no close date, or perhaps it's out of date. Take a look at that, 2018. That needs some updating. Progressing on, I might not even know who owns a particular contact. Who's my point of contact for this particular opportunity? And look at this, missing address data. It just can't go on, right? So at Continuum, we had similar sorts of issues. We use a HubSpot, which is a cloud-based CRM system. And this is our solution on how we sorted our own data quality issues out. Popping over to here, this is our Power BI visualization, which is the endpoint to the template which you just saw visualized a moment ago. I simply log into here Monday morning, first thing, and I can then track from source the number of issues that I've identified in my Alteryx program. Come in here, I can track the trend of issues over time. You can see that's nicely going down. I can have a look here, see the number of issues for the owner. Maybe you might expand this to be per team if you've got a large organization, for example. I can see the type of different issues that I've got here and a variety of other information. Of course, this is all completely customizable by you. Now, once I want to take a look at the details of these issues, this is a bit of a summary here, but when I dive a bit deeper, I've actually got a list of issues right here. Give it a click, and it's gonna pop open a table, which you'll see visualized. You can see who the owner of that particular issue is, what it relates to, what the issue is. And since we've got a cloud-based CRM called HubSpot, we've actually utilized Alteryx to compile automatically the URL of the affected page. That means I can click onto this particular URL from my dashboard and it automatically pops open my web browser and I'm directed directly to the page where the issue resides. I simply make the change within the system, close that down, I come back in this visualization and tackle the next one and essentially get that list down to zero. Now, the interesting part here is if I flick back to my summary screen for a moment in time, take a look at the bottom right of your screen right now. You can see an update dashboard button, which is within this visualization. This is the cool part, because once I click onto this button, a Power Automate job is gonna kick off. And what that's gonna do is it can communicate with Alteryx via an API. Once I click that button, goes to Alteryx, says, rerun that job for me. Okay, fine, Alteryx kicks off, goes into source, brings all of that data in, joins it, transforms it, prioritizes the issues, and then gets it out into my data store, which is then pushed directly back to this visualization. As you can see here, it takes approximately 45 seconds for that entire process to run. So as I go through and chop off all of my issues, I click on to run, I can see the effects of my change. And I essentially manage this list down to zero every single day, making it a whole lot more effective and easier for me to manage within my organization. Now, I hope that's taught you a little bit about data quality and the importance of data quality in running your organization. Now, data quality is the precursor to any good or successful data migration project, which happens to be what our next video is all about. If you want to learn a bit more about that, go ahead and click onto this video next to learn how we at Continuum help our clients with data migrations.